Anonymous News. As the world turns, what's new has our full attention. Courage is contagious. Join us to post what mainstream media will not. The truth. If you don't want this read to you, click links below. Thanks. NutraSweet Company brags about the second coming of Aspartame Neotame now taking over world markets. Monday, February 20, 2012. When the NutraSweet Company first began petitioning the United States Food and Drug Administration, FDA, to approve aspartame as a food additive back in the early 1970s, it had every intention of conniving its way to success by whatever means possible. Today, after successfully getting aspartame approved and widely accepted around the world with flawed studies and behind-the-scenes manipulation, NutraSweet has once again done the same thing with a new chemical sweetener known as Neotame, which is currently approved for use in food without even having to be labeled. As we reported on recently, Neotame was approved by the FDA back in 2002 without so much as a single conclusive, independent study proving its safety for human consumption. And yet the agency gave its full blessing not only to Neotame's approval for use in food, but also for its unlabeled use. As far as we know, not a single food product currently sold in the United States indicates that it contains Neotame. 2 years before the FDA approved Neotame, the Monsanto company sold the NutraSweet company to J.W. Child's Equity Partners II, LP, a private equity firm that also owned the Sunny Delight Beverage Company and Mattress Firm, among other companies. At the time of this purchase, NutraSweet issued a press release bragging about how Neotame would drastically change the sweetener industry, even though it had not yet been approved for use. Commenting on the company's plans for Neotame, Nick Yarosa, a former senior vice president at Monsanto who was given the position of president and CEO of NutraSweet at the time the company transferred ownership to J.W. Childs, had this to say: "The NutraSweet company revolutionized the sweetener industry in 1981 with the introduction of aspartame, and we intend to do it again with Neotame when we receive approval from various regulatory agencies around the world." Just as predicted, NutraSweet strong-armed FDA approval for Neotame in the United States in 2002, and quickly expanded approval to at least 69 other countries in the following decade. But the company presumably still has a lot of work to do if it hopes to bring Neotame to the same level as aspartame, which is sold in more than 100 countries and used in more than 5,000 consumers' products used by 250 million people worldwide. As detrimental as aspartame is to health, Neotame is potentially far worse. Like aspartame, it is linked to severe neurotoxic and immunotoxic damage because it metabolizes into toxic formaldehyde and other toxic substances. And because it is unlabeled, the general public is unable to self-regulate consumption levels. Please help, share this article with others, see links to this below, thanks. The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.